Oh boy, so I could not use OBS Studio in Ubuntu. I was trying to figure it out. So it's under the GNU license. So I think I can record, and maybe this will help other people. So in Ubuntu, it looks like this is the best recording software. So let's try the Quick Start guide. OBS Studio Quick Start. Just follow these four steps to start streaming or recording. Now we're recording, I hope, the entire screen here. One, run the auto configuration wizard. If you're new to OBS, or just want to get started as quickly as possible, follow the steps in the Auto Configuration Wizard. This wizard will automatically test your system and attempt to find settings that your PC can handle. This includes streaming or recording, resolution, bitrate, encoder, streaming provider, and more. You can always modify the settings manually later. The wizard will show the first time you run OBS. If you need to run it again, click on Tools, Auto Configuration Wizard. Two, set up your audio devices. By default, OBS Studio is set to capture your desktop audio and microphone. You can verify this by looking at the volume meters in the Mixer section of the main OBS Studio window. If they aren't moving or you suspect the wrong device is being captured, click on Settings, Audio, and select the devices manually. Mac OS users need an extra app. Three, add your sources for video. Next, you'll see that the preview is a black screen. OBS does not capture any video by default. To get started capturing, you need to add a source. At the bottom of the window is a box called Sources. Click on the plus or right-click inside the Sources box and pick the source you want. For example, select Daily Capture. No, I'm sorry. Select Display Capture to record everything visible on a monitor. Select Game Capture, that's Windows only if you're capturing a game. Select Window Capture for non-game applications. Or select Video Capture Device for a webcam or capture card. Let's see. So Display Capture, let's read that. Display capture is used to capture your entire monitor. The options here are few, with a selection for the display you wish to capture, and a checkbox to enable or disable showing of your cursor. Okay. You can only add one display capture source per display. If you need your display in multiple scenes, make sure you use Add Existing. Okay. Sources and scenes are the bread and butter of OBS Studio and can be super powerful. Click here to read more about them. Laptop users. Here's our troubleshooting guide if your game window display capture sources still show a blank screen. I couldn't figure out, how to save. That'll be coming. All right, number four, test your stream and record settings. Double check that all your settings are how you want them in Settings, Output. Then just hit Start Recording or Start Streaming. We strongly encourage running a test for a few minutes to make sure that there are no issues rather than just jumping in to your first stream or recording. If you run into any issues or need further help, take a peek at our help portal. Once you're satisfied, you can go on to creating great content. That's all there is to it. If you want to read a more in-depth guide about the power of OBS Studio, jump into the Overview Wiki. Facts. Where are my recordings saved? Once your recording is done, you can find it using File, Show Recordings. You can change this in File, Settings, Output, Recording. I need my recordings in MP4. To ensure that your recordings don't become corrupted, it is recommended to keep your video recording format as MKV. When you've finished recording and need to convert the MKV file to MP4, click on File, Remux, Recordings. Help, my video is laggy. Depending on the kind of lag, this could be related to a slow internet connection, your game using too many resources, or incorrect settings. Read the troubleshooting guides linked below. Okay, I'll upload that for now.